Welcome back to my channel. My name is Satya Prakash Dubey. Today's topic is angle of elevation and depression. Angle of elevation. If you are looking at an object which is higher than you, then an angle of elevation is formed. We will try to understand angle of elevation with the help of an example. Look in the picture. There is a person looking at an aeroplane which is higher than him. So line from him to an aeroplane is known as line of vision. And a line from him towards the object is known as horizontal line. And the angle formed by these two lines is known as angle of elevation. So what is an angle of elevation? It is an angle formed by the line of vision and the horizontal line for an object above the observer. Angle of depression. If you are looking at an object which is lower than you, then an angle of depression is formed. We will try to understand angle of depression with the help of an example. Look in the picture. There's a boy standing on the top of the building. And he is observing at the car which is running on the road. So the line from observer to the car is known as line of vision. And the line from the observer, means from the boy, towards the car is known as horizontal line. And the angle formed by line of vision and the horizontal line is known as angle of depression. So what is an angle of depression? It is an angle formed by the line of vision and the horizontal line for an object below the observer. Now here we are going to see some questions based on angles of elevation and depression. So here we have first question. While landing at an airport, a pilot made an angle of depression of 20 degrees. Average speed of the plane was 200 km/h. The plane reached the ground after 54 seconds. Find the height at which the plane was when it started landing. Now first we'll make a figure as per given question. Now here you can see there is a plane landing. So here A is the position of the aeroplane, and here AC represent line of vision, and here we have line AD which represent horizontal line, and the measure of the angle formed by this two line is given as 20 degrees. Now your seg AB represent height of the plane from the ground. It means we have to find out here the length of segment AB. Now we'll join point P with C. Okay, now look at in this picture, in this diagram, angle DAC and angle ACB are alternate angles, and we know that alternate angles are congruent when the lines are parallel. Therefore, measure of angle ACB will also be 20 degree. Now here we have a right angle triangle ABC in which angle C is 20 degree. Now here the average speed of the plane is 200 km per hour and time taken by the plane from A to C is 54 seconds. Now here we are going to find out the distance traveled by an aeroplane, that means length of side AC, and we know there is a formula for finding the distance. The formula is distance equals to speed into time. Now here speed is 200 km per hour and time is 54 seconds. So we'll get here 200 into 54 seconds. Now we'll convert 54 seconds into hours. As you know that 1 hour equals to 60 seconds. Sorry, 1 hour equals to 60 minutes and 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. Therefore, 1 hour equals to 3600 seconds. So we'll convert 54 seconds into hours. So we'll divide 54 by 3600. We'll simplify this, we'll get 54 upon 18. So AC equals to 3 km. Therefore, the distance traveled by plane from A to C is 3 km. Now in right angle triangle ABC, we know the length of side AC, it is 3 km. And we are going to find out your AB. So with respect to angle C, AB is the opposite side and AC is the hypotenuse. So we'll find sine 20 degree using osa chota, which I had explained you in the last video. So sine 20 degree equals to AB upon AC, and value of sine 20 is already given, it's a 0.348. so we'll substitute the value of sine 20 and AC, and we'll simplify further. We'll get AB equals to 1.026 km. We can convert into meter. For that we need to multiply by 1000. So we'll get 1026 meter. So the plane was at a height of 1026 meter when it started landing. Now here we have another question. A boy standing at a distance of 48 meter from a building looks at the top of the building and makes an angle of elevation of 30 degree. Find the height of the building. Now we'll make figure as per given question. You can see in this picture there's a boy who is looking the top of the building. So line from him to the top of the building is known as line of vision, and the line from him towards building is called as horizontal line, which is given here 48 meter, and the angle formed by this two line is 30 degree. Here AB represent height of the building, so we have to find out your AB. So this is our diagram as per given question. Now we'll take right angle triangle ABC, and here we'll use 10 of angle 30. Why we'll use a 10 of angle 30? Since here BC is given 48, which is adjacent side with respect to 30 degree, and your AB is the opposite side with respect to angle 30 degree. It means we know the adjacent side and we have to find out the opposite side. Therefore, we'll use 10 of this angle, that is AB upon BC. We have used it again over here, osa chota. Now we'll substitute value of 10 30 degree using that table, and its value is 1 upon root 3. So we'll get 1 upon root 3 equals to AB upon 48. So AB equals to 48 upon root 3. Now we'll rationalize the denominator. We'll multiply numerator and denominator by root 3. So we'll get 48 root 3 upon 3. After simplification, we'll get 16 root 3. So AB equals to 16 root 3 meter. Hence, the height of the building is 16 root 3 meter. Thank you. Do like, comments, and subscribe for my channel.